People don't talk about the stress that Black people endure. And when you see so much of people dying that look like you and you're desensitized to it, that goes into your stress, that goes into your trauma, generational trauma and historical trauma, and that leads to worse health outcomes, which is how my artistry ties into the healthcare system. And that's why I'm so passionate about public health and everything. Hi, my name is Gabrielle Milton. I'm a D2 at Tufts Dental School. I'm the president of the Social Justice Literacy and Advocacy Club, also the president-elect of the Student National Dental Association. I really enjoy art and dentistry because I feel like dentistry is an art. I feel like I'm back in the studio creating new art pieces. And I just feel like there's a lot of correlation. I'm from Charleston, South Carolina. So a lot of the racial injustices that were going on during 2015 when I was a senior is what led me to most of my art concentration pieces. This is probably my favorite piece because I was able to incorporate myself in the piece. So if you look in the left-hand corner, you actually see my reflection. And I feel like so many Black women can resonate with this piece. During this time, growing up, I had chemically straightened hair, which is perm. So a lot of African-Americans get perm hair to basically assimilate. We are all just trying to chase these European standards. It's just crazy how we have to assimilate. We have to code switch. We have to straighten our hair. So after doing my research, I decided that I want to go natural. So I stopped getting chemically straightened hair or perms. So I cut off all my hair and I was constantly bullied. I was even bullied by family members. I've been in internships with biracial directors that told me they don't like my natural hair. And if they had known that I had my natural hair like this, they wouldn't have hired me, even though I'm going to do the same job. I would constantly post these pictures from magazines of natural Black women, and I put them all over my bathroom. You could not see the wall. And I constantly had these people to look up to and aspire and to motivate me. I feel like Black women, we are the backbone of everything. We're the backbone of civil rights movements. The Black Panther Party was led by Black women. Martin Luther King had a group of Black women behind him. And I'm really excited to see where Black women continue going. And I think this is the time where we need to empower Black women. I love 9 Mile Road to Education because it's my mom's favorite. And this story is about my grandmother who would have to walk 9 miles each day with her two friends to and from school. I just want to represent her. So her shoe is the one that's on the ice because she has a smaller foot because the other two people that she would walk to school with were older than her. And it was really disappointing because she would walk past and there'd be people on buses, white students that'd be laughing at them while they walk through all different types of terrain, different weather to get to and from school just to get to the education that they so desperately need. Early 1900s nightmares, I actually won an award on this for the best concentration piece. I entitled it Early 1900s Nightmare because it was about my great-grandmother. My grandmother actually told me this story. And she was living in Georgia at the time. And she went for a walk at night and walked in on somebody being lynched. So she could not sleep for 3 months. If you look at this piece, you will notice that there's 3 parts. So the top portion is the rope, the noose, and then there's a pillow, and then there's the feathers. I wanted this to be very eerie, but also beautiful because art to me is gorgeous, but I needed to prove a point. During George Floyd and during Breonna Taylor's death, that was a really hard time for me during dental school. There were times where I did not get any sleep. There were times like days where I would not eat. I lost a lot of weight during George Floyd while on top of us living in a pandemic, we have to go through racial injustice. So this early 1900s nightmare, it resembles what modern day lynchings are to me. I resonate so much with this piece, and I resonate with my great grandmother who couldn't sleep for 3 months because I couldn't sleep too from watching this. I feel like in order to bring about change, you have to go through some uncomfortable situations, which is one of my favorite quotes that I live by. Black people's history has been swept under the rug, and I wanted this art piece to be as loud as possible. I think this time has taught everybody to be empathetic. Are you willing to see these issues within your family and these issues within yourself? And what are you going to do about it? It's one thing to live in a privileged bubble, but once you see all these issues, what are you going to do that's going to stand out?